Have you ever wondered what makes a supercomputer super? Come with us as we walk through the components of ROSI, MSOE's GPU-powered supercomputer. A supercomputer is made from similar components as laptops, such as CPUs, volatile memory, storage, networking, and GPUs. The difference with a supercomputer is that there are many high-performance components in one cluster, designed to work together on really large computational jobs. The result is a single computer made up from many smaller computers that is able to maximize throughput and minimize latency. Central processing units, or CPUs, are general-purpose computational engines, and ROSI has two CPUs in every computational node of the cluster, with up to 20 processing cores each. Volatile memory is short-term storage for the CPUs. More memory helps improve performance of large computational problems and helps support multiple users using the same systems at the same time. Each computer in ROSI has at least 384 gigabytes of RAM, and some of the nodes have as much as 768 gigabytes. For high-performance computing and AI applications, the data is too large to fit on any single hard drive, so a centralized high-performance storage array is required. ROSI uses NVMe SSDs both on the nodes as well as in the central storage array for the fastest possible storage performance. ROSI is networked with fiber optic Mellanox InfiniBand plugged into PCIe bus of each node, ensuring the highest throughput, lowest latency connection possible. Networking between the GPUs of the NVIDIA DGX systems use an even faster, higher throughput system called NVLink. If you're familiar with gaming, you've certainly heard of a GPU. The graphics processing units, or GPUs, that are part of ROSI are not designed for gaming. In fact, ROSI's GPUs have no HDMI ports. ROSI's GPUs are, however, an evolution of the GPUs that enable modern 3D graphics in games, movies, and animation. A GPU is a specialized computational processor that's extremely fast and efficient for a specific type of calculation, matrix algebra. Matrix calculations are at the heart of computer graphics and AI, which is why GPUs are necessary for accelerating AI applications. Each node of ROSI has multiple GPUs with a minimum of 16 gigabytes of GPU memory each. MSOE students and researchers can access ROSI from anywhere and request whatever computing hardware is needed for the task. Many students can be using ROSI simultaneously, and you can even run multiple of your own jobs at the same time. One of the primary tools used in AI is a Jupyter notebook. This digital notebook can run on any node of ROSI and allows users to write code, display graphs and plots, and write comments in a single, easy-to-read report. For power users, ROSI can be accessed via the command line and can run programs of virtually any language. ROSI currently has 3 NVIDIA DGX-1 nodes, 20 teaching nodes, and 4 management nodes. All nodes are connected via InfiniBand as well as an Ethernet backbone for connection to the campus network. ROSI currently has over 1,000 CPU cores with 10 terabytes of RAM, almost 100 terabytes of NVMe SSD storage, with an additional 400 terabytes of spinning long-term storage, and over 100 GPUs with a total of 2 terabytes of GPU memory. ROSI will be scaled up and upgraded as new GPU, CPU, and networking technology is available in the coming years. Training complicated AI models requires supercomputers that can store, move, and process large amounts of training data in parallel. It's critical for students to learn the skills of how to use a supercomputer to optimize performance of computational jobs and be able to develop the algorithms to solve the computational challenges of the future. ROSI provides a hands-on learning platform unique to MSOE, designed for students to develop and refine their AI and high-performance computing skills. Learning with industry-standard tools in a hands-on environment from faculty with industry and research experience is what makes MSOE the place to be to learn AI.